Welcome everybody to Wrestle Strong Dojo. My name is Jack Heller and I'll be your host this evening. 12 entrants enter the Turnbuckle Tournament with the goal of becoming the Fighters Champion. In our main match tonight, there'll be 3 turnbuckles. One will take you straight to the main event, one will eliminate you, and one will send you straight through to semi-finals. Let's get the action started in center ring for our Turnbuckle Tournament. In the ring, we have, representing the Greasers, it's Flame. Flame is a former women's champion and has held tag team titles all across Australia.
And the wrestler that has drawn number 2 entry. Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome at this time,
Ladies and gentlemen, Tristan Slade is coming into this matchup. Former tag team partner of Flame. I'm assuming that they're still going to be friendly after this match, but we're going to be having these two in the match, getting this started.
Come on, baby!
Interesting dynamic to start this match off. Both of these two individuals know each other so very well. They've tagged together for a number of years. They know each other inside and out when it comes to this ring. Already the disrespect shown to the referee. Tristan is trying to get in there straight from the get-go. Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, as this match carries on, as your general manager, I will be, I'll be playing some wrestlers' entrance musics throughout the match, and bringing them into this matchup. But at the present, as we say, we've got 2 tag team specialists in the ring here. Flame has held women's title here at WrestleStrong Dojo for quite a long time. Oh! Turnabout is fair play. Slade to the headlock. Trying to get a little bit friendly with Flame there. We'll see if this pays out for him. Oh, Flame now with the headlock. Tristan almost joining us in commentary there by the sounds of it. The Flame, the fans are on the side of Flame. Oh! Or at least at this point of the match. Dojo fans telling Tristan Slade what they think about him in this one. Oh! What a move. Look of shock on Tristan. Can't say I blame him. Flame read that one. She probably seen this happen more than once. Oh! Hurricane Runner from Flame. And this is how you get the rest of Strong Dojo fans on your side there, Flame. By beating up your tag team partner. You'll notice, ladies and gentlemen, at ringside, DB Robertson, the former Fighters Champion, had to vacate the title due to injury. Oh! What a shot from Flame. Power slam by Tristan Slade. I'll tell you what, we almost could have got 3 there, and he probably would have had some breathing room there. Flame's already feeling it in this matchup. Oh, he won't do that, will he? Oh, and a miss. Out of these 2 greases, I think we know which ones the fans appreciate more so. Again, these two know each other so well. Tristan Tsang, right there, he knows exactly what Flame was going to do. Years of teaming together. You learn what your tag team partner can do. You know what they're about to hit you with. That may not end well for Tristan Slade in this one. Tristan trying to get the early submission in this one. But even still, if he does get the early submission here, he could be eliminated. One of the turnbuckles will eliminate you. One will send you to the finals, and one will send you through to the semi-final. The competitor that goes all the way in this matchup will be added through to the semi-finals. And coming to the ring at this time, let's find out.
Here's the next. Coming to the ring, entrant, Omen!
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Omen coming to the ring. Representing Lucha Loco Australia. We've seen Omen here for a number of years. He is an enigma. He shows up when he wants to. He disappears for long periods of time. And seems to be sporting some new tattooed ink on those sleeves. Even after everything that's been going through at the beginning of this matchup here, Flame still saving her man Tristan Slade in this one. Oh, feeling that. Oh, famous are there. Don't they realize that you eliminate everybody, one of you is going to be making it through to the finals. Trouble in Paradise here with the Greases, ladies and gentlemen. Vance telling them how they really feel there. Oh, the experience of Omen right there getting out of the way. Looks like Tristan's now trying to go for the pin. I'm not sure whether or not Flame's shoulder is fully down. Referee's in a great position there. No, he's waved that one off. Either he let her up then, or she got her shoulder up. Oh, trying to go meeting of the minds. Oh, we got that meeting of the minds there. Oh, there we go. We've got the three count there now. So this match should be paused. So Tristan's now deciding which turnbuckle he's going to be going from. Look of a trail on Flame there. She's pinned by her own tag partner. Let's find out what the outcome will be in this one. It looks like Tristan Slade hasn't gotten a turnbuckle to take him through the finals in this one. And Omen's back in the ring, taking it to him. The match is continuing. Oh, kick out there by Tristan Slade. Omen comes into this match. The enigma, the wild card in this match. With Omen, you don't know what you're going to get. What a power slam, though. And an elbow drop. May take a little bit more. Yeah, it's going to take a little bit more to put away Tristan Slade in this one. Oh, the precision on Tristan Slade being able to actually get through the eye holes of that mask. Oh, don't chop him. Oh, no, don't lick your hand. No. Oh, the fans are getting in on it. No. Oh, What a dirty player. Can't say it doesn't get results though, can we, ladies and gentlemen? Probably not the best corner to be in, boys. While we're getting the turnbuckle fixed up there. What a clothesline from Tristan Slade, Omen. WSD officials on the outside just securing the turnbuckle. And that turnbuckle will be secured so that it will not be able to be taken off in this matchup. Got a two count there. Tristan Slade is getting a bit angry there. What does he have to do to put away Omen in this matchup? As we're approaching about the 10-minute mark in this match, he's gone through all of this. He's gone through Flame, and now he's got Omen. Count there by the referee. Referee again in a great position there. He's gone to Specsavers. He's got his glasses. He's ready to go. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, who's just coming out? There's Joe. It's Tony Sin. Tony Sin has entered the Turnbuckle Tournament. And has automatically eliminated Omen. Tony Sin enters this match and picks up the quick pin. Ladies and gentlemen, this feels like The Price is Right. The contestants are asking the fans how much the item is, but which turnbuckle they should go to. Is Tony Sin going to pick that top?
The Netherlands, Henry, or Hell?
Hell! He's deciding about whether anyone wants to pick Hell or not. I never thought, ladies and gentlemen, that I would hear a Hell chant. But hey, I've seen a lot of things in all my years as a broadcaster. He's complaining about the double knots. That might have been me. We won't let him know that though, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, I wrote that one, ladies and gentlemen. I am so glad Tony Sin picked that one. We're gonna get this match restarted. The respect being shown there.
You are forgiven in the name of the Father, the Son, and Tony Sin.
Oh, we should have known that was coming. Couldn't happen to a better man. Say what you want about Tristan Slade, ladies and gentlemen, and many people have, but he's been in there against two amazing competitors, and now Tony Sin's in there with him. If he can survive the onslaught here and make it through to the finals, we might have a new fighters champion in Tristan Slade. Oh, he's feeling that. Like only Tristan Slade can with the elbow right there. Oh, two count. Fisher's in a great spot once again. Haven't had any problems with this official. Oh, right to the gut. What a snap, man, ladies and gentlemen. Kick to the back, but I think the big news here. That That's right, ladies and gentlemen, the Panther Rain is on his way to the ring. Tony Sin, not happy that I made this call and brought Dean Draven out at this point in the matchup. History between these two men. They fought back at the beginning of 2024 in an epic no DQ matchup. One of the most brutal matches I've seen here at WrestleStrong Dojo. Right here, you've got a Grand Slam champion in the ring against former tag team champion in Tony Sin. And a former tag team champion in Tristan Slade. Tony Sin has also won heavyweight championship all across Australia and all across England. The old adage says Draven's gonna kill you. Look, in this match, he very well might. Oh, what a clothesline. Fans requesting another one. Suplex from Draven there. If anybody does it better, I haven't seen them yet. Oh, breaking up the pin. Reminder, ladies and gentlemen, we've got three turnbuckles here. One will send you straight to the main event. The other will send you to the semi-final. And the last one, well, that last one's going to send you packing out of this tournament. All over the top goes Tristan Slade. Oh, kick to the gut on Draven. God's favorite son, Tony Sin, has made an impact since coming through to the WrestleStrong Dojo roster. Having won the tag team titles up in Bathurst, having some amazing matches here at WrestleStrong. But again, you cannot count out Tristan Slade in any situation. He will find a way. That's 2-on-1 beatdown now. It's one of the advantages of this type of match. You get yourself a partner, and you start working over somebody. Well, that's a great idea.
I still want the belt.
It's hard to fault Tristan's logic there. He still wants to become Fighters Champion. Could very well be these two in the finals going for that Fighters title. Two count there by Tristan. Draven powering out of this one here. John Ranger is on the scene here at WrestleStrong Dojo. We've seen Ranger compete up at Oberon recently in singles action, and here he is. He's entered this turnbuckle tournament. He wants that Fighters title. I was having a chat with him earlier on, and he said the blue belt will match his blue gear. And he's on fire entering this match. Doesn't want to burn up too quickly though. Tristan hugging the ropes there. Again, can't say I blame him when you've got this young upstart at you. He's coming in, fighting with all of his heart. Unlikely team here, Ranger and Dean Draven. Oh, a nice bit of tag team action there between these two. Draven just holding to pin him. It's a good question there, Ranger. Please don't. I don't think they care. Oh, we're going for a Ranger chop. I wasn't bad there, aren't you? Oh, Ranger, you may have just sealed your fate there, my friend. What a shot to the young Ranger. Oh, Dean Van sent to the outside. Oh, these two working over Ranger. So what, there is a fire in this kid. He's like the little Energizer Bunny from hell. Oh, what a nutcracker. Ranger, your facial expression said it all. That smile. Fortunately, only a two count there, but Draven's on his way. Is Draven coming back into the ring? Tony's definitely feeling the effects of that one. Double suplex right there, Tony Sin. Said it before, I say it again, the unlikely team of Ranger and Dean Draven. Kick out at two by Tony Sin. Oh, Dean Draven on a roll there. Ladies and gentlemen, I've just received word. That was a three count.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match has now been paused. Tristan Slade has been eliminated.
Props have to be given, ladies and gentlemen, to Tristan Slade, who is entry number two into this matchup. And he has lasted this long into it. There are three turnbuckles, two of which will give you glory. One will send you home. One will send you straight to the finals. One to the semi-final. And the last one will send you backstage. This sold out arena here at Penrith Gales. I'm enjoying this action. For the record, I didn't write that one.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dean Draven has joined the eliminated card and has been eliminated.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, you hear that? The match went from four competitors down to two. Ranger and Tony Sin. Officials are working at getting the turnbuckle fixed up there. But the match will restart. Yet to enter this matchup, competitors such as Sahara, Zachariah the Messiah, and Joey Fox, to name a few.
Ladies and gentlemen, entrant number seven to this match, the one, Joey Fox!
Speaking of which, Joey Fox on his way to the ring. Grand Slam champion in his own right there. Former heavyweight champion. What a suplex straight away to Ranger. I had a chat with Joey Fox before the matchup today. He's coming into this match with something to prove. He's a former fighters champion, having won the title down at Goulburn back at the end of 2022. After losing the heavyweight title recently, I think he's trying to focus back up and start collecting some gold. Ranger becoming the fan favorite here. The heart that this kid's showing. But Joey Fox, what a knee. Joey. Ranger shouldn't have gotten involved there, mate. Live to fight another day. Oh, when you go one-on-one with one of the longest reigning heavyweight champions, you're going to understand why he held the heavyweight title for as long as he did. These two have had battles in the past. These two met back up at Singleton in 2022. November was the month, with Joey Fox walking out with the win. Since then, these two have not been in the same ring at the same time. Oh, what a chop to Ranger. We are witnessing history here, ladies and gentlemen, at Parents Gales Club. The fans are wanting one more. Oh, Ranger's going to be feeling that tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen. I guarantee you that. One more. Wind up. Ranger says, no thank you sir, I do not want another. And just shoulder drives into the stomach of Joey Fox. I don't know where this kid gets his energy from. From Ranger. Oh, Tony Sin able to save the matchup. As I say, what an outstanding performance by Ranger in this matchup. He's like the Energizer Bunny from hell. He's not going to give up. Then you've got Tony Sin, God's favorite son. Grand Slam champion, Joey Fox in this matchup. Turned this into a singles match, at least for now. But when will the next competitor enter this match? And who will it be? Oh, Canadian Destroyer, Joey Fox. Tony Sin hasn't moved. This song sounds familiar. Is that?
Ladies and gentlemen, entering the match now.
Ladies and gentlemen, CJ Young has something to prove entering this match. A chip on his shoulder. Last time he was in the ring, standing across from Joey Fox. Joey Fox and Aragon, the Fox unit, had defeated CJ Young for the tag titles back in 2022. That's got to be on the back of the mind of CJ here as he clubs at the back of Ranger. Oh yeah, CJ Young with a chokeslam. And Joey saving the matchup for Ranger. Might be best to roll to the outside, Joey. Get a little bit of air, a little bit of time in this one. Just flopping on him with headbutts there. Oh, and that elbow drop by CJ. We've got some Ranger fans, we've got some CJ fans, and we've got Joey Fox fans in the house, ladies and gentlemen. Ooh, shoulders into the abdomen of Joey Fox in the corner. Those big shoulders, just going to be feeling that. Boot to the head of CJ Young. CJ looks like he tried to hold on, but it was a bulldog nonetheless. By Joey Fox. Ranger, realizing what was happening at the last minute, then made the save. Trying to send CJ to the outside. Might be actually doing CJ a bit of a favor there, give him a little bit of a rest. he's not doing it. Styles Clash by Joey Fox. And somehow Ranger has kicked out of the Fox Clash, we'll call it. Frustration starting to set in. And he just kicked himself in the head. And he did it again. A third time. I think Joey Fox was getting frustrated and then confused. And then all of a sudden, he had CJ Young running at him. Person we don't want to forget about. Tony Sin sitting out there on the outside. He's had plenty of time to rest, while the three other competitors have been tearing each other apart. Band roll to the outside. Joey Fox and Tony Sin. Oh, Joey off the pole. Ranger is doing his best. CJ over the top rope. Ranger, don't do it. I know what you're thinking. Ranger off the top rope, but Tony Sin has managed to get out of the way. Smart call by Tony Sin. Three men are down and he's ready to pick apart the bones. And Ranger off the pole. What can Ranger do to get out of this predicament? Raises edge. Oh. I think it might be over for Ranger. Valiant effort on the behalf of Ranger. Amazing work by Ranger in this matchup. That will be on many highlight reels for this young man. This is the second elimination Tony Sin has secured in this matchup. Tony Sin has just made his way to the final round. And we got CJ Young and Joey Fox back in the ring. From four, once again, we're back down to two. Oh, what a knee by the one, Joey Fox. And another one. Slim. Match is starting to take its toll, I think, on Joey Fox. He's got that shoulder strapped, having a hard time picking up CJ Young then. Alistair Fleming, the former MMA fighter. In the last 12 months, he is the only person to make Joey Fox tap out. Now, that was in non-title action, but he comes into this match with a big advantage over the former heavyweight champion. He comes into this match full of energy. Although these two teaming up on him there, energy levels probably dropping very quick. Oh, rock of a baby. Although it was not lights out for Alistair Fleming in this one. What a headbutt by CJ Young on Alistair Fleming. Alistair Fleming has been making a bit of a name for himself here at WrestleStrong Dojo. But since CJ Young has made his return back at Oberon, we're seeing a different side of CJ Young. What a suplex there. And he's going for the three. One, two. Oh, managed to kick out. Joe Fox, fearing the worst, rushed the ring then. Team up and we can take him out together, he says. We've seen alliances in this match come and go. Let's see if this is going to stick. Oh, goodness me. These two working together. That is dangerous. When they're instructing each other to throw each other, we know we're in trouble. Wait, this music. That's...
Ladies and gentlemen, representing the Fight Club,
oh, James Long coming into this matchup. Two members of Fight Club in the ring. Two former MMA fighters with impressive win records right there. Made the transition to professional wrestling. And haven't looked back. As a team, they have been rather dominant, causing havoc here at WrestleStrong Dojo. This 2-on-1 mugging of Joey Fox. Oh, Samoa drop right there. Trying to make sure that CJ stays out of the equation there, as they target the former heavyweight champion Joey Fox. His throat's feeling that there. Oh, just a two count
there.
CJ, a lot to be said about this matchup. The heart and the strength of Joey Fox in this matchup.
The heart and the strength of CJ Young in this match.
CJ Young not giving up in this contest. Not going to give up there. Poetry in motion of sorts by the Fight Club. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is where teaming with someone can certainly help you out. Unless, of course, one of you make it through to the semifinals, you're out of there. So do you wait for all of the competitors to get into the match and then target each of them systematically? CJ Young is going to feel that in the morning. Hell, I can feel that sitting right here. Fans supporting the teamwork here from these two. Double suplex. Fans in the audience reminding them that was only two. It's only going to add to the frustration that James Long and Alistair Fleming are feeling right now. And Joey Fox back into this matchup. Be interesting to see what happens if we're in a situation of James Long versus Alistair. Would we get 5 minutes of them just hanging out with each other, or would they give it to each other as well? James in there protecting his boy. Right, the haymakers to Joey Fox. I tell you what, Alistair, what a character. What an individual. These kicks. The Messiah Zachariah is entering the match, making his debut here with WrestleStrong Dojo. I think he might be more interested in talking to the fans than getting in the ring.
with the Fight Club in the ring, I can't say I blame him altogether. Clothesline from the Messiah, yet another one. I spoke to Zachariah before this match, asked him how he feels making his debut. He told me he's been training for quite a long time, he's envisioned this, and he's prepared, he's ready to become the new Fighters Champion. I reminded him of exactly what he needs to go through in this matchup, but he assured me he's got it in the bag. Taking the action of former heavyweight champion Joey Fox in this. Oh, DDT. Two count there. What are the Fight Club doing here? The Fight Club. It's that dog mentality on the outside. They're taking out CJ Young. And in the ring, you've got Joey Fox and Zachariah. Oh my god. CJ Young's just gone through the stairs. He hasn't moved. These two in the ring should be keeping an eye out on what's going to be happening. On the outside. Oh, spine buster. James Long rushing into this matchup. Working on the arm of Zachariah. Might be good that he's already got his arm wrapped right there. If these two keep going, they'll pick a body part and they will tear it apart and then make you submit. That's just the mentality of the Fight Club. Alistair just ripping at the arm. The fans, don't give up, Zach, is what they call out. Zach's trying to get back into this. But can the Messiah do it? Or is he just a naughty boy? We'll find out now. All the props in the world to CJ Young for trying to get back into this matchup. Alistair to Joey Fox, two members of the Fight Club taking on Joey Fox and Zachariah the Messiah. Oh, Joey Fox in a predicament position. James Long with a Tiger Faint Kick, better known as a 619, but a Tiger Faint Kick nonetheless. We got some trouble in paradise here with the Fight Club. Oh, bit of language there we're going to have. But CJ Young doesn't forget. Gives him an, oh yeah. Who's CJ going after first? Oh, sends James Long to the outside. Is Alistair Fleming next? Oh, Sister Abigail. Oh, Zachariah the Messiah saves the matchup. I can't count the amount of wins I've seen CJ Young pick up with that Sister Abigail. And a second one. And we have three. James Long on the outside, he is upset with what he sees. CJ could either send his way straight to the semifinals right now, or he could get nothing. Let's see if he can undo this knot firstly. Thank you. competitors trying to get this match started.
We'll be waiting until the referee calls for the match to be restarted.
CJ Young has not received anything there. But Joey Fox frustration is setting in there. Has already taken it out on one of the opponents there. Is this the forming of a new team there between the Messiah and CJ Young, or just some mutual respect for two guys with long hair? Ooh, let's go with Joey Fox.
Representing Mystic Nation, it's Sahara!
Oh, Sahara coming to this matchup. I've had the pleasure to be ringside for Sahara's matches here at WrestleStrong Gojo, and I'll tell you what, they bring a different energy to their matchups. A scream you don't want to be close to. And an athleticism you wouldn't imagine. Asking if that's Jesus. Sahara taking aim at Zachariah the Messiah. All the other competitors have got a smart idea. Just stay in a corner. Stay away from the action. Catch your breath a little bit in this one. Oh, and a DDT by Sahara. Sahara with a two count there. Joey Fox trying to take them. Oh. Hurricanrana by Sahara. Or as I like to call it, a Sahara Pinrata. Zach's trying to get out of the ring in this one. I can't say I blame him. Get yourself some air, mate. James staying away. CJ Young's doing some cartwheels on the outside. James Long trying to stay away from him. Sahara attacking both the boys. Oh! They'll be telling to see who they go for. Oh! Right hand by James Long. Sahara, braver than you might think, going straight in there against CJ. James Long, ooh, popping a slap through all of his efforts. And that kick into a DDT on CJ Young. Two count by James Long. James Long's able to kick out of that one there. Messiah Zachariah. Oh! Just got a nutcracker right there. His future children will be feeling that one. Referee did a good job to get out of the way on that one. Spinebuster by James Long. Winning this matchup, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to advance your career. It's going to take you somewhere that you weren't previously. There's so many competitors in this match who have not held singles gold here at WrestleStrong. Imagine if we have in our finals Tony Sin versus Zachariah the Messiah, Tony Sin versus CJ Young, Tony Sin versus Joey Fox. The only limitation is your imagination. And CJ Young, Looks like he's been put through those stairs once again. James on throwing Zach's head into there. Another Tiger Fang kick right there. I believe Zachariah's got some fans in the audience there. Wants to mock them. While he hits another Tiger Fang kick on the Messiah, Zachariah. Better known as the 619 by Rey Mysterio Jr. Oh! The dirty tactics there, James Long. Being caught by Zachariah. He's not going to take it too much longer. Oh, look at that guy. Impaler DDT. Can he get a three? His foot was under the bottom rope as well, but still a kick out of two. CJ doing his best to get in there and break up the pin. All of these competitors want to make it through to the finals. But to do so, you're going to have to get through the semi-finals. And only two of these competitors will get there. Who will it be? Oh, CJ has taken a beating in this match. Joey's coming into this one. Oh, Joey's coming into this one with quite a bum-looking shoulder by the looks of it there. Probably why he couldn't get all of that roll up on Zachariah the Messiah there. When you wrestle as much as Joey Fox has been, that will happen. But what a kick to the back of the neck of James Long by Zachariah the Messiah. As Zach got him. Oh, the Messiah's gonna put him down. No. Oh, and a kick. Think it might be over for the Messiah. Oh, we've seen that spear from James Long before. Referee needs to be a bit better with their communication towards the announcer's table. Sahara attacking James Long after he's already won this. This moment, this pause, Sahara doesn't care.
James Long has been eliminated.
James didn't even get
this
to pick his.
This match will be paused again while Sahara selects.
How do I always get screwed?
Ben, turn on.
Sahara making their choice.
Shut up, Sahara!
Oh! Which is Sahara gonna pick? Will it be one of the blank ones that I put in there? Or will this be the semi-final card? Let's find out.
Spot.
You heard that here, ladies and gentlemen. Sahara trying to run off with the turnbuckle, but this one-on-one matchup between these two will be for the other semi-final position. And I tell you this, these two have met in tag team matchups in the past. They've been part of Battle Royals against each other, but this is the first time CJ Young and Joey Fox have gone one-on-one. And it is one of the biggest matches in CJ Young's career. If he can get the win over Joey Fox, he gets it to the semi-final against Sahara. Joey Fox, on the other hand, he has something to prove after losing the heavyweight title. He wants championship gold, and he wants to get back to the top of the mountain. But both these men have been in this match for a very long time. CJ getting dropped there. The shoulder of Joey Fox working that bit better for him. Leg drop there. Bit slow with that leg drop there in the cover. That could have impacted that. Joey's sound signaling that he's ready to put this one. He's ready to put this on the bed. As I say, the last time these two met, it was in a tag team match all the way back in 2022, in which the Fox unit defeated the Solution for the tag titles. Here we are now. 2.5 years later, oh! What a matchup between these two, I tell you what. Joey channeling the fans in this one, he's ready. He's calling for the Flying Fox. CJ is feeling it there. Stamina is gone. Flying Fox. And there we have it.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner in this contest and moving forward in the Turnbuckle Tournament, Joey Fox!
Hear that first, ladies and gentlemen. Joey Fox versus Sahara. Yeah. Will be the semi-final matchup for the Turnbuckle Tournament. The winner of that contest will advance to take on Tony Sin in the finals. I've been Jack Hellering. Thank you so much. And have a wonderful evening. We'll see you next time.